to Honda Center. It's game two of this first round series in the Pacific Division between the Calgary Flames and the Anaheim Ducks. And ahead to Patrick Eves. Eves, who had an assist in the game one win, carries behind the goal, trying to center, went off the side of the net, gets lost into the slot, looking for Bielsa, and again off a Calgary stick. Elliott has to make the save. Remember, the first goal of the game on Thursday went off the stick of Derek Engelin. Trying to get it to the near side post. It was blocked. Nick Ritchie in his Stanley Cup playoff debut out there right now. Holzer keeps it. Ritchie got it to the net. And a glove save through traffic by Elliott with Perry parked at the top of the crease. Bumped hard by Markowski.
Yeah, Markowski got a real good angle against Nate Thompson. And he didn't have any kind of option other than to chip that puck in deep.
Montour up on the play, leads it for Silverberg. He scores!
I think Elliott whips. I think he just flat out whips on the shot by Jakob Silverberg.
It's Perry into the Calgary zone. Throws it towards the net from a bad angle. It went wide. Bielsa went for the hit. Bennett comes up with the puck. Takes the shot off the shoulder of Gibson to the corner. Shea Theodore now with three assists in this series as he got the second helper on the Silverberg goal. Getzlaf chips it up the right boards to himself, puts it behind the net, knocked out, stepped in! Ricard Raquel took it away for Brody, and a surprise Brian Elliott unable to get to the post.
But watch Raquel behind the net, that puck's up in the air, he bats it out of midair, catches the goaltender looking the wrong way. And this is not a memorable start for Brian Elliott.
Looks across, takes a wrist shot, blocked in front by Kessler. Kept by Stone at the right point. Lindholm with a fluttering puck that he can't get to settle. Comes in front and back checking. Silverberg drops into the slot to intercept. Good defensive play by Jakob Silverberg, and you can say that every night. Gets a little pressure from the Calgary penalty killers. Frolik knocks it off his stick. Theodore comes over, can't keep it in. Here's a shorthanded break for Backlund. In on Gibson. Score!
And Backlund, with a quick little move, is going to bring it back to the forehand side. He had a similar breakaway last game against John Gibson, tried the very same move. Gibson beat him. This time, however, Backlund, the shift from forehand to backhand. Oh, what a huge goal for Calgary.
Giordano steps in front. Silverberg. Kessler rescues it on the near wall. Nice pass. Cogliano walks in front. Chipped away by Elliott.
Yeah, it's a good play by Brian Elliott. Good use of the goal stick there.
Nearly got a redirect from Kessler. Stretched ahead. Here's Goudreau behind the defense. Missed his shot. Went over top. Gibson was deep as Goudreau coming with all kinds of speed. As the Flames roll it in, Tkachuk pursues to the near corner. Frolik got a hit on Lindholm, who tries to protect the puck. To the point, it's Hamilton. Brings it to the middle, lets it go. Knocked down in front, it lays between the circles and sent wide by Backlund. Monahan rescues it across. Versteeg had trouble handling it, can't get the shot away. Behind his back for Brody. Quick puck movement into the middle, they score! Nice looking play, Sean. Monahan has tied the game.
And Monahan makes himself available in the middle of the ice in all-in-one motion. He's just going to spin right between the hash marks, lay the stick blade down, and drill it.
Giordano double-teamed by the duo of Raquel and Eves. Back come the Flames as Hamilton up on the rush. Looks across. Brower had to settle it as he took the shot. Now down on his seat of his pants as Gibson. Still loose. Is over the cover.
Oh, what a stop by Gibson.
Nice play there. Puck comes back down the wall. Dramatically engages Versteeg, brings it in front, turns on the backhand, put it right into the crease. Bennett got a stick on it. The net is off behind Gibson. Everybody crashing into the Anaheim netminder.
Well, John Gibson was shoved back into the net. I still think he got that puck before it crossed the line.
I think he still has it outside the goal line.
The puck crosses the line. But the question is, does Chiasson push John Gibson over the line and not allow him to make a play on the puck?
The determination.
After video review, call the ice stands. There is no goal on the play. There is no turn interference with the goal.
So if you got to take a punch.
Underway in the third, and Raquel all alone in front. Theodore got it to him but he couldn't field the pass cleanly. It'll come around on Alex Chason's pass, picked off in the middle of the ice by Lindholm. Right back in for Thompson. Nate Thompson in the backhand, puts after his own rebound. Cogliano swats it away from Elliott.
Yeah, smart play. Is trying to make a pass essentially off the goaltender's pads. Just throw it into the middle of the net. The rebound was there for Andrew Cogliano, but good patience shown there by the goaltender, Brian Elliott.
Calgary defender to the corner. Theodore up on the play, gets it back to Getzlaf. Passes it across, Silverberg settles it. Right through, got it to Theodore. Elliott looks behind him, but he's got it under his left arm.
Yeah, he was looking to squeeze that puck between the arm and the body of Brian Elliott.
Face-off win, comes right to the slot. Silverberg had a poke at it, and now it's poked back by Eves to Getzlaf. His pass across. The skate of Bouma and in! Oh, my! Off a Calgary player. Getzlaf was trying to pass it. It ricochets in. The Ducks lead 3-2.
You never know.
Draw comes to the boards. Lindholm tries to chop it loose. It does come loose. Getzlaf just feathers it all the way down. Will they get an icing call? No, they won't. So Anaheim has a 2-0 lead in the series.
The Flames have got to be thinking they're never going to win in this building. They played as well as they can play. Boy, another two-point night for Ryan Getzlaf. Dominant performance in the face-off circle once again. This one wasn't pretty by any stretch of the imagination.